Namaste and welcome to Sonali Joshi's Astro Jyoti Healing. In this video, we are going to see the astrology-based guidance for the month of May. I am going to cover the major transits. Before going on to the various signs, let us see what are the major changes that are going to happen in the month of May. Month of May is a very happening month astrologically. And what are the reasons for that? The first reason is Rahu is conjunct Mercury, Sun and Venus. That means all the signs owned by these planets will be affected. Saturn goes retrograde and this will bring out the karma that is due for most people for whom Saturn is very important. Jupiter goes into the nakshatra of Rahu, that is Shatabhisha. This is major transit of Jupiter through Aquarius. And if these many changes were not enough, we have lunar eclipse in the nakshatra of Jyeshtha. So let us go over the summary of signs that will have direct or indirect impact of these planet transits, that are Capricorn, Aquarius, Taurus, Libra, Gemini, Virgo, Sagittarius and Pisces. And obviously the sign Leo, obviously Cancer due to the eclipse. What are my important messages for the month of May? Number one, make all the efforts to keep the negativity away. Use your natural wisdom to help others. Most important is take care of your physical as well as emotional health. And the last one, but the most important one, do not make any abrupt changes, sudden changes during the week of eclipse as well as the time when Saturn goes retrograde. And the dates are, now let us begin with all signs, and this is the guidance or the tips for the signs to get the most from the month of May. If you have moon in Aries, Mesha Rashi, expect some slowdown at work. Expect some hurdles, have more patience. If you have moon in Taurus, Vrishabh Rashi, always remember, too much of anything, whether it is holding, collections, food, drinks, is always bad. So share things. If you have moon in Gemini, Mithun Rashi, you love news, media, communications. However, aggressive communication doesn't solve the problem. So try to calm down. Use all the methods where you can. Talk to other people in a way that you don't come across as an aggressive person. If you have moon in Cancer, Karka Rashi, you may notice emotional ups and downs, and you may notice other people are trying to slow down whatever your plans are. It's always good to know it beforehand and then rearrange your expectations. If you have moon in Leo, Simha Rashi, use your friend circles, network circles, all the gains that you have to help others. This is your biggest opportunity. If you have moon in Virgo, beware of the fact that bosses as well as your mentors can be sometimes very selfish. Talk to them. Take advice from them, but use your own wisdom to decide what will work in this time frame. If you have moon in Libra, Tula Rashi, your ability to reject all the negativity, your ability to see the best from the person you are dealing with, your ability to find nice things, values in the person that you are dealing with will help you bring back the balance at workplace as well as in personal life. If you have moon in Scorpio, with the eclipse coming and Mars getting into the sign of Mercury, you may feel the aggression, you may feel the urge to do extreme when it comes to competition. I would suggest take things with patience and slow down. If you have moon in Sagittarius, Dhanu Rashi, there is only one important tip for you for this month, and that is If you are looking for any big business partnerships or you are looking for any romantic relationships, be cautious. Think about the situation from all aspects and then make a decision. With Saturn going retrograde, it may happen that people will have to redo certain things in this month until October. If you have Moon in Capricorn, your Rashi Lord Saturn goes retrograde in the month of May and it is going to continue till October. The best thing to do is do not make any abrupt changes around that time, and there is some karma that needs to be paid off. So you will go through certain situations which are not very happy situations. If you have Moon in Aquarius, Kumbha Rashi, your Rashi Lord Saturn goes retrograde and your thinking can sometimes slow down, change abruptly. However, Jupiter going over your Moon will always give you wisdom, will always show you the path. Use that wisdom to help others. Aquarius is a sign that is known to do karma for others. So please help others in your own capacity. If you have Moon in Pisces, Meen Rashi, with so many changes happening in the month of May, you may notice the emotional turbulence. The most important thing to remember this month is, if you are looking for any big investments, do them thoughtfully and always make sure you understand the facts and you decide in a way that you put others first. I am also going to share the weekly messages or the weekly predictions for the month of May soon. Please watch them. Also look out for the videos related to eclipse, Saturn retrograde, Jupiter moving into Shatabhisha. All these videos together will be helpful in deciding what actions you can take depending on your Rashi or your Lagna. Share this video with your friends so that they are also well equipped for the month of May. Thank you for all your responses, comments and the donations that you have been doing to the charity. Hit the subscribe button if you are new to this channel and I look forward to hearing from you. Namaste. Thank you. Shubhamastu.